become more more awake, or to trigger them into awakening and to help and assist through their ascension. Help one another. We all help each other, you know, through this beautiful experience that we're all going through right now. But sometimes, like me, when I started, I didn't even know what the heck was happening to me. So, you know, I was called to start helping. So I'm on this beautiful mission of assisting other beings of love and light, just like I am, to help you understand some of the stuff you don't understand, why you're going through it, or why you keep seeing all these numbers and synchronicities everywhere. You're not going crazy, you're just awake now. So now we're just going through ascension, and this last full moon that we just had, it really put people through the ringer. It still is. And a lot of the shadow energies or memories or past experiences that were not great for you, you know, they came up, okay? They were triggered to come up so you can deal with them and finally put them to rest, you know, put them in the back burner and say, okay, I've dealt with you. I felt it. I am grateful and I am thankful for those experiences, but now it's time for me to step up and become more conscious of, I can't ever really say that word, conscious, be more conscious of, get into a higher consciousness of yourself. And that's what ascension is, just growing and growing and growing and just going. Instead of going backwards, you got to keep going, going, going. And even though sometimes we have like little stops and bumps in the road, but we deal with it and it stops for a little while and then we get back on it, because that's what it's about. It's a learning process, and just be grateful and thankful for all these blessings and lessons that we're learning in this beautiful thing, you know, movie we call love. I've been meditating a lot more. I have, well, except for yesterday, because I was nervous packing and getting ready to come over here to San Francisco. But, you know, we've been going through a lot. A lot of the energies we've been going through are very heavy. You know, our universe wants us to get rid of all the muck so that we can start building new earth. New earth is here. We're just, you know, we got to start building it. It's a slow process, but it's here. The event happened, and we are the event. We are the ones that are making change, big change in our lives, by waking up and understanding that we are beautiful beings of light having a human experience, okay, people? We're not human beings having a spiritual awakening, no, okay? We just forgot. We had amnesia, but now we are remembering. We are being triggered as much as we can so that we can understand who we truly are. We are very magical beings. We are huge. We are beautiful. We are joy. We are happiness. Everything. We can be in the shadow as well, and we have to accept that part of us where, you know, that's the human part of us, okay? We're mixed. So we're using these vessels that we call a human body to navigate through the earth, okay? The 3D is very dense, so our bodies and our mind became very dense. But now that the shift went through and we're all starting to wake up from that dense slumber that we were in, you know, it's starting to feel better. I feel my energy very different. If there's negative people around me, I know how to shield that energy from not entering my energy, my aura, my spirit, my mind. It took a while. It's very hard to be able to do that. Well, at least for me it was. I'm not sure how it felt with you. But it took a while for me to understand and to have trust in myself, in my universe, in my spirit. Took a lot of learning. I researched a lot. I read a lot. I'm following my intuition now 100%. I don't let anything outside of me push me into doing something I do not want to do. I'm just living my best life. This was given to me. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. I am living my best life because I came here to love. I am the seed of love, of great, beautiful, angelic love. And that was my mission that I promised to myself before I incarnated in this body. I've been doing it for thousands of years. It's just that when we came to this earth, we forget. We're born with amnesia, so we put all these triggers and obstacles and situations throughout our lifetime to trigger us into awakening. And sometimes it's quickly, and sometimes it takes a very long time for some people. But it's okay. It's okay because right now you're experiencing it no matter whether you like it or not. You know, there was enough of us awake in order to help Mother Gaia make this shift so that the others can awaken and get rattled and awakened, even though they were slumbering away in their caves. But no more. Everything is awake now. Even the birds, like I hear, oh my gosh, it's so beautiful how I hear. I connect with the energies of all animals. I went this last couple of months. They have been very, very strong. I've been connecting a lot with peacocks, which remind me of, I feel the energy of the blue avians through the peacocks. You know, that's what I feel. Other people feel them through other energies. But this is what I'm going through. I've experienced negative beings as well, but because I know and I trust that I'm okay, I do not let them in. You know, and when I say that, it's when we let them in, when we start doubting ourselves, when we feel depressed, when we start overeating, overdrinking, you know, getting drunk for no reason. I don't drink. I don't like beer. I do like wine and I do like alcohol once here and there, maybe for Christmas or New Year maybe, but I don't like beer and I don't like alcohol. I do like wine and I only drink wine maybe once or twice a month when I do my rituals and stuff. But it's just been an amazing, amazing journey, my awakening, and to understand what it is. I'm still learning so much. We never stop learning. That's the beautiful thing of it. We learn until the day we let go of this vessel and we move on to the next. That's another great thing about being a multidimensional being. There is no such thing as death anymore. Like, not the cruel death that we've been told that, oh my gosh, you're going to go to hell, or if you're not good, you're going to go. No, no, no. Those were just scare tactics that they put in our brains so that they can keep us at a low vibration and always keep us dense and in the shitty realms of this beautiful Mother Gaia. You'll start understanding all of it once you, you know, you're going through your ascension, you're going to start feeling things and you're going to start connecting to different energies and synchronicities, and you'll understand, you're going to put all the puzzles together. And when you do, when you start putting puzzles together, it's so beautiful. You go through all these magical experiences, and they just make your whole body fills with pure love, like pure euphoria. Okay, even whether you do ayahuasca or San Pedro or peyote, any type of, you know, plant medicine, whether you do it or not, you will still go through it. But the ayahuasca and all the plant medicines, they help you go through ascension easier and better. There's more understanding, you know, at least to me, for me, because I've done ayahuasca, I've done San Pedro, I have done Combo, Bufo, and they have all been beautiful experiences, except one, but I understand it, and I am fucking completely grateful and thankful because, oh shit, I'm getting a little teary-eyed, but no, I don't want to do that, because it showed me, you know, all the fucking shit that I did in my past lives, and that I might not be so proud of, but I am grateful for them because they were experiences just like all of you guys. You know, there is no good or bad. There just is. And we just gotta let it go that there has to be a bad and a good. No, we all came here to experience things. We came here to experience being in the third density. We came here, now we're experiencing the third, the fourth, and the fifth. You know, you just gotta work through your ascension in order to be able to anchor that fifth energy, that fifth density, that fifth dimension, whatever you want to call it, so that you can keep your mind, body, and spirit in that fifth dimension. Because when we do that, it's a beautiful place to be. I've been tapping into it here and there, and because right now I'm in the fourth dimension, and I keep going back and forth, and it's okay to do that. You know, sometimes you go back into the third as well, because you just got to go deal with things that you got to go close those doors of what you still need to do, you know, in the third. But once you're done with that, you jump into the fourth. In the fourth, it gets a little tricky. Fourth density, there's a lot of back and forth. Sometimes you get a little unsure of yourself. Sometimes you're thinking you're going crazy. Sometimes you're like wondering, what the hell is this? Why am I going through this? Why am I having these feelings? You know, and it's okay to have negative feelings. It's okay to have sad feelings. It's okay to have mad feelings, because you're awake now, so you're gonna, those feelings are going to be triggered so that you can deal with them. Let them come through your mind and your body and spirit, and just be grateful when they come up for them. Just say thank you for this experience, but now it's time to put you away. And I'm not saying that you're never going to feel the experience of being mad again, but you're going to know how to handle it much more better than before. Okay, that's the thing. Before, you know, you get mad or you get sad or you feel angry, and you just want to feel that way for days and days. And there's people that feel that way for months and years. There's people that feel that way their whole life, and they die and they didn't have not one day of peace. And that's what I'm here to help with, is to trigger you and to help you out through your ascension, to help you understand why you're going through all this, because I'm going through it. The star seeds were awakened first. We were triggered to awaken first so that we can go through it and be able to be the forerunners, the way showers, the star seeds, the helpers, you know, and to help maintain, not order, but to help everyone understand what it is, because we've gone through it already, and I'm still going through it. You know, whatever I can, I put out videos to let you guys know. travel to your home as well. If you are not able to travel to mine, I'm going to San Francisco right now. You know, I gotta heal the family. When the family calls, I gotta go, because the family, you know, family's family, and you know, with their I have a huge ass fucking family, that's for sure. I'm the only one left in LA, in Los Angeles area. Everyone else is up north, San Francisco, Sacramento, San Pablo, Pinole, you know, I don't know, there's all kinds of other cities, and they're all spread it out, because we're a huge, very huge family. I think my grandma had like 17, 18 children. You know, some of them passed, but we're a very huge family though. I'm gonna go trigger my family, whether they like it or not. I won't force it on them, but I know that my energy has triggered a bunch of them already, because they're starting to call and wondering, okay, what is Chuyita talking about? Everybody calls me Chuyita over there because my name is Maria de Jesus, so that's short for Chuyita is short for Maria de Jesus. They're wondering. Some of them are, you know, weirded out about it, but it's okay, because you know they're not understanding. People usually fear something they don't understand. I know it, because I used to fear shit. So, and it's okay. It's okay. I'm very patient. I think I'm the most patient person in my whole entire family, because to grow up knowing that I knew that I didn't belong here. Shit, that takes a lot of fucking patience, a lot. So I know there's more out there, but you know, some of them just haven't came out in my family members, you know. My cousin, two of my cousins, like two or three of them, they're, you know, they were like in a shell, but they're starting, you know, to come out, and it's awesome. I love it that they're finally waking up to knowing who they truly are. I'm just so happy that more people, more of my family members and other, you know, other people from the collective are starting to be more curious and, you know, want to receive more help from me and other star seeds, other healers. You know, it's an awesome thing to know that we're making a difference. We're all in this together. We're all here as a group, as a collective, to help Mother Gaia ascend into the fifth dimension. When she was born, she was born as a fifth dimensional being, but because we became so dense and full of hatred and full of all this negative shit going on, you know, people killing, unnecessary killings, the horrific things that happen that other humans do to other humans, you know, rapes, you know, molestation, human trafficking, all that shit. It's going all the way. It's going all the way. Okay? So, we're going to be living in a world. It's the age of Aquarius. More love. Try and be in waters, you know, at the beach. Take baths. Put a little bit of Himalayan pink salt in your bath and just chill in there for a good 20 minutes to half an hour. Listen to your meditations. Turn a candle on. Put your crystals there. And believe me, that's going to help you so much, because it's going to take away so much of the stress of everything, of the ascension and of just day-to-day things. You know, the kids, the job, the careers and all this other stuff that we've gotten ourselves involved with, you know, which is okay too, but you know, this is going to help you deal with things better. Everything is going to be seen more through love and the third eye, instead of everything through the mind and the ego, you know, the human brain and the ego, which has gotten us into this dense world we're living in, or I should say we were living in, because want. Because when you want, you stop yourself from moving forward and from ascending. You can't live in that mentality, you know, of wanting and wanting. Just be grateful. Be grateful and thankful for what you have. Because maybe the person down the street might not have what you have. They have less. And you should be grateful every day. The first thing you should do when you wake up is freaking tell your universe how grateful you are for freaking waking up, you know, for being, for breathing, because our universe can just say, all right, it's time to come up. Here's your ticket. Come back home. You know, we're here on Earth to have a beautiful human experience. We came here to navigate this world and to dream on it and to live like kings and queens, you know. We didn't come here to suffer and die away with all these diseases and shit. We came here to have a beautiful, beautiful experience. And the things I've seen, I've seen the future, and it's amazing. The fifth dimension, living in the fifth dimension, you know, it's not living in it, but experiencing it. It's such a magical, beautiful, beautiful thing, and like, it's like living in pure euphoric bliss, okay? That's how I can explain it. I had a energy download the other day, and my daughter was in the car, and she experienced it. She got a little bit freaked out, but everything was fine, and she's going through her ascension as well, and she kind of was fighting it for a bit, but she's not anymore, so she's happy. I think she's happy. She's happy for what she experienced with me, and I'm happy that she got to see something, you know, because I usually, when I get those, I'm usually alone in meditation, and I don't get to experience them with anyone. What I do is oh, that's another thing, guys. Journal. Journaling is an awesome thing to do. Try to journal your dreams. Your dreams are messages from yourself that you're sending with your angels. You're sending yourself so they can guide you. So pay attention to your dreams. Pay attention to your synchronicities. Pay attention to the beauty in life, okay? Go out there, try and be in nature as much as you can. Try and be in water as much as you can, because that's what we're moving into. We're moving into the heart space, into aligning with your chakras, and connecting with beautiful source, connecting with your oversoul so that you can live a better life, so you can understand why things happen. And not live so bitter and angry and sad all the time. I'm telling you, because I've experienced a shitload of things in my lifetime. My dark side experience began, I've always said this, began October 5th. awesome, awesome rest of your week. And email me if you need to. Text me. Send me a direct message, whatever you want. I love you guys. Have an amazing, amazing day. It is Wednesday. On a mission Wednesday, and I'm on my mission to San Francisco. All right, guys. I love you. Namaste.